WWDC21 has just passed, so today we're going to be playing around with the new capabilities of text, canvas, timeline view, and some new backgrounds. Be advised, we're going to be using Xcode 13 beta, the first release, for this exercise. We'll create a new app, WWDC. To test out this new view, we'll create a mock login view. Let's start with what's new in text. So in text, we could always do string interpolation, as in we have a string and then we can add some custom methods that we're doing that produce other strings. But now what has been released is that inside the interpolation, we can use other text views. This is very important because we can customize the text to look differently. As you are seeing here, I'm creating a text inside of this string, and let's add a bold modifier and look at the preview. We can now build different text as if we were creating an NS attributed string. It's not just with the font, we can also change the foreground color. I'm going to move it to another variable that I need to declare text so that the interpolation works. And here in the preview, we can see how the color will change to blue. Another new thing that was released was backgrounds with material. In the preview, you can see how this material was applied to the background of the text. Let's move the material to the bottom of the screen and let's also apply an H tag so that it uses the entire width of the view. This we can accomplish by using spacer. We'll later add a continue button, but I want to emphasize this text. So we're gonna create another text in this string and we're gonna make it bold. Let's add a different type of background. Let's create a title here. We just add coding with Tom. And let's apply the background modifier, but this time, instead of passing a material, let's add a color. Let's try cyan. And in the second parameter, you can specify the shape that's being drawn with. You can see here an ellipse, and it was drawn in the background of the text. Let's add these to an H tag again. Let's add a spacer so the text moves to the left. And let's change the ellipse to a rounded rectangle. And good. This will be our title. Let's move on to using one of the new views introduced in iOS 15 and that I'm very excited about, the canvas that lets you draw like how we used to do in UIView and draw in rect. During canvas, you add the view and in a closure, you specify the context and the size. Inside the closure, we can draw things just like we did in drawing rect. We're gonna specify a frame. And now let's start drawing in the canvas. So the first thing that we're going to draw is an image. We could create an image just like we have done with image and passing a sustained name, but that'll mean that every time that the canvas is redrawn, it will load the image again and again and again. So to be more efficient, we ask the context to resolve this image. And then we can just draw the image. There's a bunch of methods for this. For now, let's use draw image at point. So we'll specify a point. Right now, let's just draw this in the point 50-50 and let's see. So there it goes. Keep in mind the coordinate 0-0 is at the top left. Now let's draw this logo 10 times. For this work, we can use a for loop inside of the canvas. Notice how we can declare variables and everything inside this closure. Now let's evenly space out these 10 logos. Okay, here we have our logos. Let's fix this a little bit. And let's also add some padding, as well as make the canvas a little bit bigger. Now that we have drawn images, let's try drawing paths. Again, just like we did with UI Bezier path, context can draw a path. And to get the path, we can also use shapes. So for example, here in circle, we can get the path that the circle would use in a specific rect. So the shape that we're going to be drawing will be a background circle for each of the logos. We need to first draw the circle and then the image. And also let's make it a little bit more bigger than the logo size. Let's move the canvas to a separate variable, and let's also make it a little bit different by changing the color of each logo. So let's create an array of colors, and we'll choose a random element for each of the logos. Moving on, let's add some animation to our canvas. For this, we're going to use another view, which is going to be the timeline view. So we can create this with different types. We're going to use for this one animation, but there are other things that we could be using. So for what we're going to be using the timeline view, we're going to be using to keep track of the passing of time. So as time passes, we're going to be displacing the logos that we just created. For this, we use the timeline parameter. We get the date and we get the time interval since the reference date. Let's try for now just, let's apply the modulo function to the timeline reference date so that the offset is not bigger than the width of the image. Okay, I had a little bit of bumps experimented with timeline. This is my first time using it and I wasn't getting the effect that I desired. So what we're going to do instead is just apply the reference date, but we're not going to use modulo, we're going to use remainder dividing by a number. What this means is that I'll divide by 3 in this case, and we'll get the remainder, so this is not going to be a number that will grow uncontrollably, it will just stay within a specific range. Let's run the preview. And you can see now that the logos are moving a little bit. So let's calculate the offset using the size. I realized that before I was using the image size, that's why nothing was moving a significant amount. So everything looks displaced. That's okay. And let's apply the animation. Okay. Looks a little bit nicer. Let's improve it. I don't want my animation to look so monotonous. So what we're going to do is interchange the direction. So the even numbers are going to move to the left. And for that, we're going to use the modulo function to change the sign of the offset. Okay, looks much better. The last thing that we're going to do is draw text with canvas and animate it using the timeline view again. We're going to create the text in separate variables that we will be showing. Just like with fill and image, context has another method to draw text. And we're going to apply again the text interpolation that we have been using in this lesson. Okay, and there we have our text that's drawn. Now let's add a little bit of animation. We're going to use the remainder to show or hide some of the text. Since we're doing string interpolation, we can use a ternary operator to show the text or empty text, depending on the remainder value. And you can see in the preview how this is being animated. Let's apply this for the other text with different values for the remainder and see how it looks. And there we have it. Our text is being animated. And that was all for today. Canvas and TimelineView provide very interesting ways to present views in SwiftUI. I really liked it, and I hope you did as well. Bye.